Good morning.
Good morning.
God has given us many gifts, gifts of the mind, body, and heart. We are to use these gifts to serve and to help other people. At this Mass, we celebrate God's greatest gift, Jesus. We thank God for Jesus and ask for the grace to imitate the way Jesus used his gifts and talents for others. Heavenly Father, as we celebrate Catholic Schools Week, we ask you to send your Holy Spirit to guide us in truly uniting us as the body of Christ. Help us to use the gifts you've given us to grow in love as a community of people who love and serve you with our thoughts, actions, and deeds. Our entrance song is "This Is My Commandment."
This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you, as I have loved you, as I have loved you. This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you. This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you, as I have loved you, as I have loved you. This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you.
Good morning. Let's begin as we begin everything important in our lives, in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Thank you very much. Today, Jesus calls some disciples and he sends them out to spread the good news of God's love. There are times where you and I have been those faithful disciples and we've shared God's love with each other. Other times, not so much. For those times, let's ask God to forgive us. Lord Jesus, you show us the way to the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you've given us the consolation of truth and love. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the good shepherd leading us into everlasting life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and one day bring us into a life that is everlasting. Amen. Let us pray. O God, from whom all good things come, grant that we who call upon you today in our need may at your prompting do what is right, and by your guidance always be loving. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. Let's be seated to listen to God's word.
A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Brothers and sisters, you have not approached that which could be touched, and a blazing fire and gloomy darkness and storm and a trumpet blast and a voice speaking words such that those who heard begged that no noise be further addressed to them. Indeed, so fearful was the spectacle that Moses said, "I am terrified and trembling." No, you have approached Mount Zion and the city of the living God, the heavenly Jerusalem, and countless angels in festal gathering, and the assembly of the firstborn enrolled in heaven, and God, the judge of all, and the spirits of the just made perfect, and Jesus, the mediator of a new covenant, and the sprinkled blood that speaks more eloquently than that of Abel. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
O God, we ponder your mercy within your temple.
O God, we ponder your mercy within your temple.
Great is the Lord and holy to be praised. In the city of our God, his holy mountain, fairest of heights, is the joy of all the earth. O God, we ponder your mercy within your temple. Mount Zion, the recesses of the north, the city of the great king. God is with her castles. Renowned is he as a stronghold.
O God, we ponder your mercy within your temple.
As we had heard, so we have seen, in the city of the Lord of hosts, in the city of our God, God makes it firm forever.
O God, we ponder your mercy within your temple.
O God, we ponder your mercy within your temple. As your name, O God, so also your praise reaches to the ends of the earth. Of justice, your right hand is full. O God, we ponder your mercy within your temple.
Sing alleluia, sing alleluia to the Lord. Sing alleluia, sing alleluia, sing alleluia to the Lord. Sing his praise, sing alleluia to the Lord.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Mark. Jesus summoned the 12, and he began to send them out two by two, and he gave them authority over unclean spirits. He instructed them to take nothing for the journey but a walking stick, no food, no sack, no money in their belts. They were, however, to wear sandals, but not a second tunic. He said to them, "Wherever you enter a house, stay there until you leave from there. And whatever place does not welcome you or listen to you, leave there. Shake the dust off your feet in testimony against them." So they went off, and they preached repentance. The 12 drove out many demons, and they anointed with oil many who were sick and cured them. The Gospel of the Lord. Let's be seated. How many of you read the Bible? Pretty much in class, huh? We read the Bible. So, tell me this. In what book of the New Testament is there a story about Jesus building a building? There's none. That was a trick question. Jesus didn't build a building in all of his life. You never saw Jesus in any pictures or heard him in any gospel having a backpack with stuff on it or in it. Jesus didn't walk around with a piece of parchment paper with notes like I do to be able to address the crowds who were gathering around him. In all four gospels, Jesus was ever asked for his qualifications to do what he was doing. Today we'd ask for a resume. No one ever asked Jesus, "What makes you able to do this?" Jesus never comes prepared to feed people or to heal people or to touch people. What Jesus does is he remains open to God's lead. And he always knows just the right time and just the right place and just the right people to say, "Do you have some fish? What about some bread? Can you give me some water or something else?" And so today is kind of a scary gospel because God is asking us to kind of be like Jesus and trust him. And trust him. He was sending out those 12 disciples two by two. For the first time, they were leaving the mantle of Jesus and going out on their own. He made a choice, Jesus did, because he loved them so much that he was going to give them the same mission God had given him, to preach repentance, to preach forgiveness, and to preach love. The first thing you want to notice about the gospel is he didn't send out one by one. He sent out two by two. There's a huge lesson there. He gave them friends for the journey so that no one ever got lonely. He reminds us that being and building church isn't just a one-person enterprise. It takes at least two. From that moment, Jesus teaches us that we need to support and encourage each other as we carry out God's work, the work he gives us. From this day and even before that, we have a lot of examples where God doesn't leave us by ourselves. How many of you in school have friends? Most everyone, right? You have a friend. And doesn't it feel good? Because when we don't have friends, it's very, very lonely. Well, God did the same thing for a lot of people. It wasn't just St. Paul. It was Paul and Timothy. It wasn't just King David. It was King David and his buddy Jonathan. Even Jesus had a special friend. Does the name Lazarus mean anything to you? You see, their companionship came from a very common goal. They wanted to love God. They wanted to serve God and serve others. That was the mission that Jesus was sending them on. That's the mission you and I have, even to this very day. So the next thing you want to notice is Jesus sent out these disciples in 2021. He would say something like this to us second graders, okay? Don't take your lunch bag. Don't bring your backpacks. Don't bring your iPhone. Leave your computer where it is. Don't even bring your favorite book. Ugh. That's what he was telling them. Basically, Jesus was saying, the greatest witness is not all that stuff that you have out there, that you're in your backpack or whatever. All that stuff is pretty cool. But Jesus is saying the greatest witness that you and I can give to each other is right here. You, Miss Flanagan, Seminarian Adam, you, your teachers, by our lives, by our words, and by our examples. Now, just as a little side note, but it can also be kind of dangerous because sometimes we're not very good examples, huh? So we need to be careful because people are looking at us. You see, that's a gift you can't buy in a store. That's something you can't put in a backpack. Because what Jesus is asking us to do today as disciples, like he did the first ones, is not to do something, but to give a gift for someone. That someone is you and me. So what we offer each other and God must always come from hearts that are in love with God and wanting above all things to please God every day and in every way by not just what we say, but by what we do. You know, every year at this time, that's why I think we celebrate Catholic Schools Week all over the United States of America. It reminds us that while we can have pride in buildings like this, in like our school buildings, while we can have pride in our excellent teachers and our excellent academics, the most important gift of Catholic Schools Week is you, Samantha and Daniel. You, Fisher and Ava. You, Sarah and William. All of our students, that's the most important gift of Catholic Schools Week. It is you who have a theme for this year. Like Jesus sending out his first disciples, we have a mission given to us today. We're reminded that that mission consists of three simple words. The first word is faith, and then excellence, and then service. Can you say that with me? First is faith, and then excellence, and then service. Let's say it all together. Faith, excellence, and service. One more time. Okay, so Catholic Schools Week is not about buildings. It's not about technology. It's not about books and how many scholarships we win in school. Though all of those are really important, y'all. This week reminds us that first and foremost, it is about us, you and me as a people of faith.
And faith is a gift from God for all of us to share, whether we're Catholic or Baptist, whether we're Methodist or Episcopal. It makes no difference. All of us has faith to share with each other. The second thing that we've been asked to do, especially this week, is talk about excellence. Excellence means that we honor God's gift to us by being our best and by doing our best. We don't just get by. We are our best selves. It means that we value each other's talent and we encourage each other every single day to do the best we can do. And finally, there's service. Service is at the heart of what it means to be Catholic schools. When you get older, you can have service hours. It's something we do because we love Jesus, not to just put things on a paper, huh? The highest form, Billy Graham said, of worshiping and praising God is Christian service. He said the highest form is consecrated feet seeking out people who are lost and lonely. Now, most of us are not going to be Billy Graham or Mother Teresa of Calcutta or St. John Paul II, but all of us are servants in our own right. How? You can open the door. You can help someone on the playground. You can give someone else some help with some homework. You can be kind to someone on the playground again. You can say please and thank you all day long. You can share some of your goodies at lunch when someone doesn't have goodies themselves. So today, Sacred Heart, we're called to be disciples. We're called to be our best selves, to let everyone around us know, especially at this school, that we love God, not just with words, but especially with our actions and our lives. Happy Catholic Schools Week, y'all. Stand. We truly believe that God hears us and that God knows what we need. And so in faith, let's place before God everything that we bring to us with us today in this church.
The response is, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord hear our prayer.
For those who lead us in spreading the good news, that they may always have enthusiasm, energy, and love for their mission, we pray to the Lord.
Lord hear our prayer.
For the military, for the people in authority, that they may live by the values of Jesus, we pray to the Lord.
Lord hear our prayer.
For missionaries everywhere and the people they serve, that faith grow in their hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord hear our prayer.
For our families, friends, and ourselves, that we may answer Christ's call to spread the news of his love to others, we pray to the Lord.
Lord hear our prayer.
And for just in a moment of silence, let's place before God our own personal needs. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Loving God, hear the prayers that we have spoken today in faith, those still within our hearts. Answer them all according to your perfect will, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Let's be seated. So this part of the Mass is called the offertory. And we offer two things. We're going to offer the bread and in a minute the wine. It takes a lot of grains of wheat to come together just to make this one host. Okay? It takes a lot of grapes to come together to make just a little bit of wine. The reason why we offer bread and wine is because that's what Jesus did. But for us today, it reminds us that we have to put all our gifts together so that we can be the best church that we can be, the best people that we can be. So whenever the priest is up here offering the bread and the wine, don't just sit back and look. Think about, okay, today, what can I offer to God? What can I offer to God today to make people love Jesus and to help people come to Jesus and love him even more, okay? Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. It is only through your goodness that we have this bread to offer, which earth has given, human hands have made.
It'll become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God. And blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. It is only through your goodness that we have this wine to offer. Fruit of the vine, work of human hands, it will become for us spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. Let's pray that our sacrifice and prayer be acceptable to our loving God. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Look kindly upon our service, O Lord, we pray, that what we offer today may be an acceptable oblation to you and lead us to grow in faith and in love. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us together give thanks to the Lord our God. It's truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For although you have no need of our praise, yet our thanksgiving is itself your gift. Since our praises add nothing to your greatness, but profit us for salvation through Christ our Lord. And so, in company with the choirs of angels and saints, we praise you as with joy we sing.
Holy, holy, holy.
Holy, holy, holy.
Lord God of hosts.
Lord God of hosts. Heaven, heaven and earth
are full of your glory,
are full of your glory.
Sing Hosanna,
sing Hosanna,
sing Hosanna,
sing Hosanna,
sing Hosanna,
sing Hosanna,
sing Alleluia.
Alleluia.
Blessed, blessed is he.
Blessed, blessed is he.
Who comes in the name of the Lord.
Who comes in the name of the Lord.
Sing Hosanna.
Sing Hosanna.
Sing Hosanna.
Sing Hosanna.
Sing Hosanna,
sing Hosanna,
sing Alleluia,
sing Alleluia. And now we kneel. Remember in a special way today the intention for our Mass, which is for the eternal rest of Bruce Zimmerman. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending your Spirit down upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and the blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, Jesus took bread from the table, and he gave you thanks and praise. He broke the bread, gave it to the disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper ended, He took the chalice filled with wine, and again, giving thanks, he gave the chalice to his friends, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and the eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for the many for forgiveness of sin. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this bread of life, this chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have found us worthy to be in your presence this morning to minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we might be gathered into one by your Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her now to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Louis, our Bishop, the clergy, deacons, religious, and all your Son has gained for you. Remember also our brothers and our sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, especially those for whom we now pray. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, the glorious martyrs, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs with him to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Let's pray to God, who is the Father of us all. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may always be free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom and the power. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "I leave you peace, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but upon the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
We safely share peace with each other. Would you please pray with me? Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us your peace. And we kneel. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold the one who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are we called to share in the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, my soul shall be.
So good, God is so good, God is so good, oh so good to us, God is so good, God is so good, God is so good, oh so good.
Thank you.
So this is Catholic Schools Week, and I hope you've had a good time so far. What I want you to do is this. This is the time of Thanksgiving, always after communion. It's time to tell God thank you. What I want you to do today is thank God for your mom and your dad, for your grandma or your grandpa, or whoever it is that helps you to come to Sacred Heart Catholic School. That's a big sacrifice, y'all. And I think everybody knows that. It's a really big sacrifice. So in just a couple of minutes, a couple moments, take some time right now in silence to thank God for your mom or your dad, for your grandma or your grandpa, whoever sends you to the Catholic school, okay? Y también hay un anuncio para la comunidad hispana. Gracias a Dios, la hermana Claudia va a regresar a nuestra parroquia. Espero en dos semanas más o menos. So, gracias a Dios porque ayer ella ha obtenido su visa para trabajar otra vez aquí en el Sagrado Corazón en los Estados Unidos. So, gracias a Dios. Huh? Oremos, let us pray. As this reception of your Holy Communion and blessing, O Lord, foreshadows the union of your faithful with you, so may it bring about unity in your church through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. This Mass is ended. We go in peace to love and serve God and then to love and serve each other. Thanks be to God. Y'all have a great day. I want to hear you singing, okay?
Jesus is the bread of life. His banner over us is love. Jesus is the bread of life. His banner over us. Is the bread of life, his banner over us is love. Jesus is the bread of life, his banner over us is love. Jesus is the bread of life, his banner over us is love. His banner over us is love.